30 seconds to go. Can only 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 30 seconds to go.
30 seconds left.
Okay, I want to talk about something that like bugs me, and it has to do with this Star Wars. As we all know, the new Star Wars movie is coming out later this year, and I, like everyone else, am very happy and can't wait to go see it. I think it's going to be a great movie. But what I do notice is that anytime Star Wars gets brought up, especially nowadays, and especially with this new movie coming out, a lot of people start hating and just saying really bad things about the prequel movies and about how horrible they were and how bad they were, and just saying, you know, that they didn't like them, and that's fine. But I will suggest and say that the prequels are not that bad. I actually like them. I think they're fun. I think they're enjoyable. Do I think they're the best? No. Do I think all of them are as good as the original? No. But I do enjoy them. The problem I think that people have with the prequels is that they were not what they expected. They were not what they wanted to see. And so now they don't like them. And the reason for that, I think, is because when we were introduced to Star Wars, most of us were introduced to Star Wars as kids. And our imaginations were captured by the Jedi and the Sith, the space battles and the ships and the lightsabers. All of that captured our imaginations, and we just gravitated to it. We loved it. And as we grew older, we kept thinking about it, thinking about them, and basically our imagination matured, and so did our ideas about Star Wars. And there's no place that it is better to see that than in the fan films. And I love fan films. I think they're great. Great quality, bad quality, I just like them. This is a pile of DVDs that I burned, fan films, because I like them, I love them, and I watch them all the time. And just as a side note, sort of, any film that we see that is a Star Wars from this point on is basically a glorified fan film. Even though this movie is claiming to be Episode 7, even though it has actors from the original trilogy on it, I still consider it to be a fan film, but that's just me, and we'll move on. Back to what I was talking about before, though, our imaginations matured as we grew older. When George Lucas made the prequel trilogy, he was in the same state of mind that he was 30 years earlier when he made the original trilogy. He was still telling that story back there. So, of course, that's the same kid-like story that he told then for us now. And, you know, a lot of people just were not happy with that. And I can understand that, but that doesn't make the movies bad, horrible, and all those things. Some of the things that people pick at, I think they pick at them unfairly. For instance, Hayden Christensen. He often gets, it's often said about how horrible he did. And some of it may have been him. I think a lot more of it may have been the way his character was written. And then also we have to consider that in the prequels, you had a character who turned to the dark side through hate, who was Darth Maul. And then Hayden Christensen, who we knew as Anakin would become Darth Vader, we had preconceived ideas about what Darth Vader and who he was and how he would be, but not that fact that Hayden Christensen turned to the dark side through fear, which I think is a lot different than turning to the dark side through hate. And a lot of the complaining is that he whined a lot, that he whined all the time. And there was another character in the Star Wars movies that whined a lot, and that was Mark Hamill as Luke Skywalker. He spent the entire episode 4 whining about how Uncle Owen won't let him go to school, and, oh, I can't take you to Mos Eisley because it's too far, I'm going to get in trouble. Then he goes to Dagobah in episode 5, and I can't pick up the X-Wing, it's too heavy, and he just whines and whines and whines. But again, Hayden Christensen, we see, and, you know, we say that's bad and horrible, because it's not what we wanted. Mark Hamill, he whines and complains, and we probably identified with it because we were kids when we saw it. So it's okay. Another thing that's often looked down upon, and I can understand it, because Jar Jar can be annoying from time to time, and the Gungans were kind of goofy, but the Gungans were no more goofy than teddy bears who are about this tall, who ran around going nub nub all the time, and then beating Imperial officers with sticks and rocks. That is just, the Ewoks are just nuts. They're just ridiculous. That final scene, that final fight scene with them and the Empire on Endor is just, it's just ridiculous to watch them defeat the Empire. It just doesn't make any sense. Now, one thing that I do suggest, and I think that you can do that will give you a better appreciation for the prequels, is the way you watch the movies. Because you can watch them the way they came out, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, or you can watch them in numerical order, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. But a good way that a lot of people watch it, and I like to watch it this way from time to time, is to watch 1 and then 4, 2 and then 5, 3 and then 6. Because when you watch it that way, you see similarities in the way the stories are told. You see the path of Anakin, you see the path of how it was mirrored in an opposite way with Luke. And I think these similarities are very interesting. There's something to explore and to think about. You can even see in the titles, A Phantom Menace, A New Hope, Attack of the Clones, Empire Strikes Back, Revenge of the Sith, Return of the Jedi. You can see, you know, how the stories might be set up to be similar. And I think by watching it that way, you might gain a better appreciation for them. And see, you know, that this was George Lucas finishing his vision for these stories. And just that's my little rant about Star Wars. Can't wait for the new movie to come out. Please give the prequels another chance. Watch them as just something fun. Look for their good points. That's it. Love, peace, may the Force be with you, whatever.
A long, long time ago, in a galaxy far away, Naboo was under an attack. And I thought me and Qui-Gon Jinn could talk the Federation into maybe cutting them a little slack. But their response, it didn't thrill us. They locked the doors and tried to kill us. We escaped from that gas, then met Jar Jar and Boss Nass. We took a bongo from the scene and we went to feed to see the Queen. We all wound up on Tatooine. That's where we found this boy. Oh my, am I this here Anakin guy? Maybe Vader someday later, now he's just a small fry. And he left his home and kissed his mommy goodbye, saying soon I'm gonna be a Jedi. Soon I'm gonna be a Jedi. Did you know this junkyard slave isn't even old enough to shave? But he can use the Force, they say. Do you see him hitting on the Queen? Though he's just 9 and she's 14. Yeah, he's probably gonna marry her someday. Jedi. Now we finally got to Coruscant, the Jedi Council we knew would want to see how good the boy could be. So we took him there and we told the tale how his midichlorians were off the scale and he might fulfill that prophecy. Of course, could he bring balance to the Force? They interviewed the kid. Oh, training they forbid, because Yoda sensed in him much fear. And Qui-Gon said, now listen here, just stick it.